Hi there and welcome to History for the Ages, where we bring to life people, places and adventures from the past. Today we will be covering a basic and important part of exploring history, that is, understanding historical sources. Before we can continue, we need to ask the basic question: what is a historical source? A simple definition is, a historical source is something that gives us information about the past. It's as easy as that. Historical sources come in two forms, primary sources and secondary sources. This is what we'll be focusing on today. A primary source is considered to be a source from the time period, generally from someone who was present when the events occurred. For example, if your grandfather fought in World War II and he was telling you about his experiences during the war, his stories would be a primary source, as he was present during the events he was telling you about. There are many different types of primary sources. This could include a letter from someone involved in the events, or inscriptions or writings on a piece of pottery known as an ostraca. Other primary sources could be a stela, a stone block with inscriptions carved into it, or a painting from a specific time period like the Mona Lisa. Honestly, anything can be a primary source so long as it gives us information from an event or time period that we, as historians, are investigating. Let's move now to secondary sources. A secondary source is considered to be a source that was not present at the events that it's providing information about. Again, there are many different types of secondary sources. Your history textbook is a secondary source, as the authors have brought together a bunch of interesting information from different sources and made it into a book. A newspaper article written by a journalist not present at the events it is talking about is also a secondary source. Consider the recent trend of making movies about historical events, like the movie 300 or Troy, or listening to a speech or your teacher talking to you about the past. These too are secondary sources. Now comes the important question: who cares? Historians care about whether a source is a primary or a secondary source, as when we are investigating people, events, or places in the past, sources from that time period, primary sources, are generally considered to be more reliable or trustworthy. If I wanted to find out what it was like to fight in World War II, I would trust my grandfather telling me about his experiences of fighting in World War II, a primary source, more than a Yahoo Answers response. However, we need to make sure that we don't slip up, as history isn't as simple as primary source equals reliable and secondary source equals not reliable. My grandfather may only be able to tell me about his experiences fighting on the Kokoda Trail, but since he never fought in Europe, he wouldn't be able to tell me about the fighting on the Eastern Front between Russia and Germany. My history textbook, however, can tell me about the Eastern Front. Does this make my textbook better than my grandfather? No. It just means that the sources are useful for different things. This is the big idea. Whether a source is a primary or a secondary source is less important than how useful it is for this specific investigation that you are researching. Let's summarize what we have learned today. Primary sources are from the time period, generally from someone who was present when the events occurred. Secondary sources were not present at the events that it's providing information about. Rather than saying primary sources are good, secondary sources are bad, we ask the question, how useful is the source for what I'm researching? Thanks for listening to History for the Ages.